My wife cut my hair. Looks pretty good, right? Well, you haven't seen the back. Joe Biden is now the de facto Democratic presidential nominee. With Bernie Sanders having dropped out of the race in mid-April, there's no one else but the former vice president of the United States left standing, or even sitting. I'm a dad, it's a dad joke. Which now means that Biden can focus all of his attention on the fall campaign against President Donald Trump. And one of the first and biggest decisions that Joe Biden has to make in that race is who he will pick as his vice presidential nominee. Now, Biden knows a little bit about that process since, well, he was a VP for Barack Obama for 8 years. So what's the biggest lesson he learned? Start early. Quote, "You have to start now deciding who you're going to have background checks done on as vice presidential candidates, and it takes time." That's Biden talking to his supporters in a virtual fundraiser in early April. He's right. And while the VP pick always matters, Sarah Palin, anyone? It may actually matter even more in the case of Biden. Why, you ask? I'll tell you. Because he's, how can I say this? Not young. If Biden wins in November, he'll be 78 years old if and when he is sworn in as president in January 2021. That's by far the oldest person who has ever been elected to a first term as president. Now, sidebar, the previous oldest president elected to a first term was Donald Trump, elected and inaugurated at age 70 in 2017. End sidebar. So given Biden's age, there's a non-zero chance that he might not be able to serve out 8 years as president. To his credit, Biden has been open about his age and how that informs who he might pick as his vice president. Quote, "One of the ways to deal with age is to build a bench, to build a bench of younger, really qualified people who haven't had the exposure that others have had, but are fully capable of being the leaders of the next 4, 8, 12, 16 years to run the country," Biden said recently at a virtual fundraiser. Everything's virtual these days. So, who will Biden pick? Well, we know one thing. He'll pick a woman. In the final debate between he and Sanders in March, Biden made that pledge clearly. Watch this.
"I'm elected president. My cabinet, my administration will look like the country. And I commit that I will, in fact, pick a woman to be vice president."
Which narrows things down quite a bit. Sorry, dudes. Tough break. So here's my look at the 10 women that make sense as Biden's possible VP pick. And these are in alphabetical order by last name, so don't judge me. Stacey Abrams. Abrams came within a few thousand votes of being the first African-American woman elected governor back in 2018. She was running for that job in Georgia. That race made her a star, and her work on voting rights issues since then has kept her in the national spotlight, and she's not all that shy about the fact that she's interested in the gig. Quote, "I would be an excellent running mate," she told Elle magazine in April. Okay. Now, the biggest problem for Abrams? Experience. The highest office she's ever held is in the state House of Georgia. And Joe Biden has repeatedly said that experience matters a huge amount to him. Quote, "You've got to be able to turn and say to your vice president, this is your responsibility, because the job is too big anymore for any one man or woman," the vice president said last August. Tammy Baldwin. Now, if you believe that Wisconsin is the Midwestern state that Donald Trump must win in order to claim a second term, well, then picking a popular senator from that state makes a lot of sense for Biden. Baldwin won re-election there with 55% in 2018. Plus, Baldwin would be a historic pick, the first gay vice presidential nominee for either major party. And oh yeah, she's a poli-sci math double major, just like me. Catherine Cortez Masto. The Nevada senator isn't a household name yet, but that may wind up being a good thing, since early buzz isn't always an indicator of future success. Remember Vice President Julian Castro in 2016? Not so much. Cortez Masto leads Senate Democrats' campaign arm right now. Translation, she knows how to raise money, and lots of it. And she has a very powerful advocate and former Senate Majority Leader and Joe Biden longtime colleague, Harry Reid. Val Demings. You probably don't know who Demings is, but check out her resume. She was the first female police chief in Orlando, Florida. In her relatively brief time in the U.S. House, she was first elected to the 10th District in 2016, she has rapidly become a rising star, being named as one of only 7 House Democrats chosen by House Speaker Nancy Pelosi to serve as managers during the Senate impeachment trial of Donald Trump. Tammy Duckworth. Duckworth is my dark horse candidate to make Biden's eventual final three. Why, you ask? Well, she's a senator from the Midwest, Illinois. she would be a historic pick as the first Asian American to appear on a national ticket for a major party. And her personal story, the Black Hawk helicopter she was piloting during the Iraq War was hit by a rocket-propelled grenade, and Duckworth lost both legs and the full use of her right arm in the incident, is both incredible and incredibly inspiring. Kamala Harris. At a virtual fundraiser in early April, Joe Biden praised the California senator for running a hell of a race for president and adding, quote, I'm so lucky to have you be a part of this partnership going forward. Working together, we can make a great deal of progress. I'm coming for you, kid, end quote. These are my eyebrows raised. Harris checks all the boxes for Biden, an African American and Indian American woman from a huge Democratic and donor state, who proved herself to be an able debater during her own run for president in 2020. Amy Klobuchar. So the Minnesota senator ran a solid, if not spectacular, presidential bid in her own right in 2020, showing that she could hold her own, mostly, against better known Democrats. Klobuchar also has Midwestern roots, a record of winning easily in a swing-ish state, and centrist politics that look a lot like Biden's, all working in her favor. Michelle Lujan Grisham. The New Mexico governor isn't well known nationally, despite serving 3 terms in the House before being elected to her current job in 2018. But she makes this list because she's one of the highest ranking Latina elected officials in the country. She also happens to represent an area of the country, the Southwest, that is growing like crazy. Elizabeth Warren. Warren has a huge following nationally, no surprise to you guys, built from her high profile in the Senate and her own 2020 presidential bid. She's also a beloved figure among liberals. But there are 2 reasons to think twice about Warren as the VP pick. One, at 70 years old, Warren is younger than Biden, sure, but not exactly of a different generation than he is. And second, Biden said in New Hampshire a few months ago that he wanted a VP with, quote, some correlation between their views and mine, end quote, specifically mentioning support for Medicare for All as a non-starter. While Warren waffled somewhat in her support for Medicare for All, she was definitely a vocal supporter of a government-run program for much of her presidential bid. Gretchen Whitmer. It was lost on absolutely no one that the Michigan governor was one of the first guests on Biden's new podcast, and that on it, he praised her as a, quote, outstanding governor and one of the most talented people in the country, in my view, end quote. Whitmer's pragmatic politics are a nice fit with Biden's, and her age, she's 48 years old, would make a clear generational bridge for him. Plus, Whitmer's profile has soared of late as she battles coronavirus in her own state and attacks Trump on the job he is doing. That's my top 10. And I'm pretty happy with it. So while we won't know who Biden settles on for a few months, what we do know is just how critical that pick will be for not only his campaign, but also his potential presidency, if he gets there. And that is The Point. We make New Point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday from my house. Be sure to check them all out.